lecture we will be discussing another non-linear named equation called as a Riccati equation. So first of all, we see the definition of Riccati equation. So a differential equation of the form dy by dx plus p of x into y plus q of x into y square is equal to r of x is called a Riccati equation, where p, q and r are some function of x. Now, if you notice one thing over here, if this q is equal to 0, then the whole equation gets converts into a simple linear equation. Okay, so only because of that q, which is present over here, as a coefficient of y square, the equation is a non-linear equation. So now, the question over here is how we solve this Riccati equation. Again, there is no working rule to solve this Riccati equation. What we do is that first we find one particular solution, and using that one particular solution of the given equation, we get the general solution, that too by converting the given equation to a linear equation with certain substitution. So what is that substitution? So I have already denoted the given equation as equation 3. So let me proceed further. So what we do is that we put y equals y1 plus 1 by u, and this is in fact the general solution if the y1 is a particular solution, and we need to determine this unknown u, which is a non-zero function. Okay, so where we substitute this, I'll call this as 4, where y1 is a particular, the meaning of particular solution is that it is one solution of one known solution of the given differential equation at certain point. Okay, so basically that particular solution most of the time is given. Okay, so y1 is a particular solution and a solution of 3, and u have to be a non-zero. Okay, u is non-zero function of x to be determined. So we assume that this is the solution and we proceed ahead. So assuming y equals y1 plus 1 by, see, this is again a method wherein we first guess a solution, and the general we observe that the general solution is of this form, that is a particular solution plus certain function of x, and we proceed by finding that unknown value that we have. Okay, so we assuming that this is a solution, is a solution of one solution of the given equation 3. If it's a solution, then it has to satisfy the given equation, that is the Riccati equation. dy by dx can be called as y prime is equal to p of x into y plus q of x into y square is equal to r of x. So first we will find what is y prime from here. So y prime is equal to derivative of this, that is y1 prime, plus the derivative of this function u is a function of x. So the derivative of 1 by u will be minus 1 by u square into du by dx, as it's a function of x. So we need to substitute, and I think only the first derivative is involved, so we need to substitute this in 5. So since I'm assuming that this is the solution, this y prime will satisfy the given equation 4. So substituting 5 in 3, we get, okay, because it's a solution that satisfy the given equation, we get I'll write down here. So you have y prime first, so that is y1 prime minus 1 by u square into du by dx plus p of x into y, that is again y1 plus 1 by u plus q of x into y square, that is y1 plus 1 by u the whole square is equal to r of x. Don't forget that this y is one particular solution to the given equation. So what we will do is that we will see that this y can be eliminated, or y can be removed from this whole expression, and we will see that since it's a solution, we can have an expression of the form y1 prime plus p of x y1 plus q of x y1 square. Okay, so that expression I'll remove out. So from here I have y1 prime, I'll remove that. From here I can remove y1 again, and from this part I'll take the first term y1 square q of x into y1 square. The reason, as you can see, that since y1 is a solution to the given equation, this should satisfy the Riccati equation, and this is exactly the left hand side of the Riccati equation, so that our simplification, our computation will become much easier if we try to cancel out the terms. And the remaining term I will write down over here. So from the first term I get minus 1 by u square into du by dx as it is. From the second term I have already removed p of x into y1, so what is remaining is p of x into 1 by u. Okay, and from the last term we will get two term, y1 square is already removed, so the next term is 2 into y1 into 1 by u plus 1 by u square, the square of the last term, is equal to r of x. Okay, now since y1 is one particular solution, it satisfies the Riccati equation, and this is the left hand side of the Riccati equation, so this is r of x, and over here this would remain same. In fact, from here what I'll do is that I'll remove minus 1 by u square common, so that again we get some linear form. I'm looking for a linear differential equation in terms of u and x. Just look at this. If I remove this minus u square out, what I'll have is du by dx plus, so that the coefficient of du by dx is equal to 1, plus what will happen, in fact this will be minus because I'm removing minus out, so minus 1 by u square you have taken out, so you will have p of x into u. Okay, minus I think I missed one term over here. This is if I'm not wrong, q of x, there is a q of x outside, so q of x, and this has to be also q of x. Okay, so minus 2y1 from here you have q of x into u. Okay, and minus from the last term simply q of x, because 1 by u square we are taking out, is equal to r of x. So this r of x and this r of x gets cancelled. And since you know that u is a non-zero function, and so that means this whole expression is now equal to zero, and since you know that this u is a non-zero function, 1 by u is also non-zero, so that's why only possibility we can have is that du by dx is equal to, okay, now here I'll take u common, so we have minus p of x plus 2y1 into q of x is into the whole thing into u, and the last term is, and the last term is, okay, that can be written on the other side, okay, minus q of x is equal to 0. So this is same as writing du by dx minus p of x plus 2y1 into q of x u is equal to q of x. Just observe this, the last equation that we have got. See, our aim is to identify that unknown function u, and see the solution. We are already assuming that this is the solution, y is equal to y1 plus 1 by u. You know what is the value of y1, that will be already given to you all. That's a particular solution. And 1 by u, here this we are choosing this u in such a way that this becomes a general solution. And so our aim is to determine this u. So basically what we do, we substitute in the given equation and see when, for what is the condition that is required for this u, so that this y become a general solution to the Riccati equation. Okay, and ultimately at the end we come to this conclusion. So u we need to determine from this differential equation, and if you observe this equation, it's a differential, it's a first order linear differential equation, because it is of the form du by dx plus some function of x into u. U is in, you can consider as a dependent variable, plus the function of x again, equal to the function of x. So this is a linear equation, first order linear equation, or linear equation of first order, okay, in u. So from here we can determine the value of u. So if you want a fastest method to solve the Riccati equation, you just remember this formula in the box, and you know the value of p and q. P is a coefficient of y, q of x is a coefficient of y square, and r of x is the right hand side. So you have this Riccati equation, its solution is given by this last formula in the box, by this differential equation. So only thing, you just need to solve this to get the solution. Let's see an example, see whether this given differential equation is a Riccati equation or not. So if I write down this as dy by dx minus y square is equal to minus 1. See, this can be written as dy by dx plus p of x, that's a coefficient of y. Here there is no coefficient of y, no terms in y, so I can call it as plus q of x into y square. So the coefficient of y square is minus 1 into y square is equal to minus 1. So if I compare this to the given equation, then in this case the value of p will be 0, the value of q will be minus 1, and the value of r will be same as minus 1. Fine. And the solution will be given by, I'll call this as equation 1, solution of, so it's a Riccati equation. And the solution is given by the general solution of 1 is given by y equal to y1 plus 1 by u, where, okay, by the way, what is this y1? Okay, first we will write down what is this. Okay, before that, that is equal to, the value of y1 is given to be 1. Okay, you can verify that this y1 is a solution to this equation. So for that, what you will do, you will substitute the value y1 over here in place of y, and see whether the left hand side is same as right hand side. So you know that dy1 by dx is equal to 0, so this first term will be 0 minus y1 square, so that is 1 square. So minus 1 square is same as minus 1, which is equal to right hand side, and therefore y1 is a particular one solution of this given equation. So that, in that way you can verify whether the given y1 is a particular solution or not. Plus 1 by u here, where u satisfies the differential equation du by dx. Now this is the formula that which we need to commit to our memory, minus p plus 2 y1 q, okay, into u. By the way, this p and q are a function of x. I'm not writing as p of x and q of x. It is understood that it is of that form, is equal to q. This is the linear equation which we need to solve, and that leads to, that is in this case we get an equation du by dx plus basically you'll get minus of minus 2, the bracket term will be minus 2 into u is equal to minus 1, which is same as writing du by dx plus 2 into u is equal to minus 1. So that's your p of x. So you know how to solve this integrating, you know how to solve this linear equation. So first we will find the integrating factor, that same as e raised to integral of p of x, in this case it is 2 dx, that same as e raised to 2x. So multiplying this equation by the integrating factor, we get multiplying 2 by integrating factor, we get e raised to 2x du by dx plus 2u is equal to minus e raised to 2x. So that is same as writing, this becomes exact equation, and that same as derivative of e raised to 2x into u is equal to minus e raised to 2x. In fact, you can directly derive the formula, but I am actually multiplying the integrating factor and deriving it, so that's not wrong. So from here we get the solution, e raised to 2x into u will be same as integral of minus e raised to 2x plus the constant term, and that is basically same as, so that gives us the value for u. So u is equal to now e raised to minus 2x, okay, and this term integral of e raised to 2x is same as e raised to 2x upon 2, the derivative of 2x, okay, plus constant term as it is. So you have u is equal to e raised to minus 2x, and 2x gets cancelled, minus 1 by 2 plus e raised to minus 2x plus c, and hence the solution of 1 is given by of the given equation, 1 is given by y is equal to 1 plus 1 by u, that same as 1 plus, this is a bit complicated term to write down in the denominator, minus half plus, okay, this is not plus, this is into, plus e raised to minus 2x into c. If you want, you can further simplify this to get a compact answer, otherwise you can leave this as the final answer for the given equation. That's all for this video. Thank you very much for watching this video.